Hello trainers, Gan Neto here and welcome to another video, and we did it trainers, you asked for it, I brought in the fight, so here comes the Shadow Zabuz video. Please be sure to leave a like, subscribe to the channel because it helps so much more than you could ever imagine. Is that a saying? Yes it is. So that we can spread around the world that we are doing some really nice and helpful videos. So Remix Cup today with Shadow Zabuz, and we're gonna be led by this Whiskas. Whiskas having a quite nice coverage against the meta because of its unique typing being part water, part ground, and now it can go pretty well against anything that is not grass. So a pretty neutral lead. Grass is not that much of a problem in the Remix Cup because people do not tend to run grass types due to too many flying types, too many fire types, too many poison types, so grass is not gonna be a huge thing. But Noctowl will be, so here comes the Noctowl. I'm trying to bait a shield and we successfully do, so now I'm just gonna force the mirror fight. If they switch out to whatever they have at the back, it's fine. If they stay in, it's also fine. I do not care about my Noctowl with this team composition. Noctowl's usage is gonna be, usefulness is gonna be when you are gonna use it as something to bait out their third Pokemon. So here we're gonna force the second shield, wow. And now we can just let the Noctowl go. Here comes the move. They're just over farming and then swap out. Yes, here it is, to the Registeel. So Noctowl did his job, and with the most successful way, because right here now we can come in with the Whiskas and go for some Mud Bombs to finish off that Registeel. And they still cannot do enough against my Whiskas with their Noctowl, because we can go right straight ahead with some moves. They're just gonna go for a move here, and that's pretty awesome because we can now bring in our Zapdos and start finishing off the match pretty easy. I'm pretty sure they can take a Shadow Ball, but I want to see how much damage we can take, and wow, that was a lot. Next time I will not do that. So here comes the farm down on our Thunder Soaker, and we're just gonna take the victory. Well played to Zapdos. Let's focus to the next one, and the mirror fight is here. Whiskas against Whiskas. I preferably go for my Blizzard straight, because most Whiskases are not going for the shield. So here comes now the Mud Shot, the Mud Bomb, and I'm pretty glad to take that, okay? And I can go now for a Mud Bomb of my own to finish off the Whiskas. So they decide to block here, and this is just fine. If that's a Blizzard, it's also fine. We can start farming down some energy with our Noctowl and then try and pressure the next shield. So they have a Shadow Charmer at the back, and that's really good for us because now we can pressure the shield with our Sky Attack, and with that shield out of the way, perhaps now we have the upper hand. Yes, we do, because we can reach another one. We have two blocks, you know what's coming. Zapdos is just setting up his eyes to the win. So here comes now, what, the Cantonia Ninetales? We do not care about that, and it's also Shadow, so it will be more than enough from Drill Peck to finish it off. But I want to secure the win, so I will just go for the Thunderbolt here after I farm a lot of energy, and down goes that entire HP from that Cantonia Ninetales. And here comes of course my Drill Peck, which can just finish off the Whiskas, and another win is ours. Next match, everyone gets Mike 99 Cool. I have no idea who that guy is, but let's see his team composition. So here comes now the Dragon Tail damage, which really adds up from the Dragalge against our Mud Bomber. I think this is gonna be the match where I screw up. Let's see. So they block. That was awesome by us, I guess. So now let's see here. I block the Outrage. Wow, what a block. And they have Feraligatr at the back. So Waterfalls really do a lot of damage, but we also have Sky Attack, which can do some severe damage to the Feraligatr. And I'm pretty sure that I can go right straight ahead and let Feraligatr hit me with the Ice Beam. Yes, here it is. Down we go, because now we can farm down with our Zapdos. So here comes the Zapdos, yes, and the farm down is real, everyone. Look at the damage, pretty awesome. We also take some damage back, but it's all good because now we have the upper hand. So they have a Raichu at the back. Oh my, look at the lag. This is bad, super bad. I do not know how much HP that I have right now, so look at that, pretty low. And I go for the Mud Bomb to finish off the match here against the Raichu, but they still have Dragalge. So I decide to block that, Yes, because that can be a grass knot. Oh my, it is a grass knot. And right now I have to force the farm down. So here comes now another move. Please don't be a grass knot. It is a thunder punch. Okay, thank goodness. And now we just have to throw one mud bomb to win the match. Right? Right? So here comes the blizzard. Nope, it is not coming because I'm an idiot. So now we have to throw the drill pack and hope that it knocks out. It doesn't. And yeah, that's a bummer. We should have gone there for the mud bomb, not gonna go for the blizzard. What was I thinking? I have no clue, but we're gonna take the loss. And next we're having the normal cast form with the hexes. Look at that energy ball. Boom, down we go. I hate that Pokemon. It counters my team so effectively. I really thought it was having only Hurricane, but I forgot about that weird energy ball. So down we go. And they also have rock type weather ball, and this is gonna do a lot against our flying types as well. So that Pokemon really is a weird core breaker for our team, but we can still have a chance because we have the Noctowl, which can do some severe damage now with the sky attack. They are gonna take it. Oh my goodness, that thing is also bulky. So we have to take now the move and rely on our Zapdos to finish off. Can we do it, trainers? We are up a shield, we are up on some energy, but we are on a tough spot because they have two Pokemon in the back. And here comes what, a ground type? Are you kidding me? What, a Nidoking? Who plays that? They also have Sandum, if they have Sandum, of course, because I don't know what moves they might have. So here comes a move with a drill pack, and we have hopefully another one. But is this enough, trainers, to finish it off? Let's see. No, it is not. Not even close. We cannot farm down at this point. And right here, here comes now the shield. Here comes the Sandum as well. And they have a Malamar. Oh my, can we do it? Can we do it, trainers? We just need to farm up to a point that we have a Thunderbolt and a drill pack ready to go. So here comes a Thunderbolt. Please be enough to knock out. Please be enough, please be enough, and down it goes, almost down it goes. Hopefully we knock out at the last second, and here comes a drill pack. What a match, what a freaking match, everyone. So down they go, and we're gonna take the victory. Wow, what a game, best season, best match so far for the season, wow. And here comes the Regis, still up in the lead. That's a really nice Pokemon to encounter up in the lead with your Whiskas. And they have also a Trevenant on the back. Sorry for that, trainer, you got algorithmed. But now we can just farm down all that energy with our Noctowl and still have a decent amount of HP left. Look at that, we do not care at all. We're just going for the total farm down. I'm not gonna block anything, I'm not gonna throw anything, just farm down the whole HP from that Revenant. And we still have enough HP to not get farmed down by Registeel. So here comes now the Shadow Balls for the Regi. It is just gonna do a lot of damage to the Regi, despite the fact that we are, oh my goodness, another one, yeah. Despite the fact that we have the Whiskas at the back, I don't care. I'm just gonna go all in with my Whiskas. And they also have one more Pokemon at the back, which we do not know what it is, but it's most probably not a flying problem because they threw in there their Registeel. So here comes now what, the Kofagrigus. That was a problem for them that we had the Noctowl, and now they might think that they have a chance. Nope, you do not, because now we can go safely for the Blizzard. I'm just gonna block once just in case, but it is just a dark pulse. So here comes now my Blizzard. Down goes a lot of HP from that Koffa, and we can safely take the next move. It takes a while for Kofagrigus to charge up, so it's all good. And I really see why they used it in their team, because of the double Ghost that they might have, double Shadow Claw. But we have the Mud Bomb, which can take their last shield, and now we can safely go for the Drill Pack, take down the Koffa, and with one shield up, the Regi has nothing to throw at us. So we're just gonna block once and then finish off the match with a drill pack. Really well played to my opponent, a nice team composition, but you got algorithmed, so we're just gonna take the win eventually. So let's focus now into the next one, everyone. And we are facing Sopulla 77, no clue who that is either. So I'm a cargo up in the lead, a really nice pick for everyone to use, but I guess the Whiskas, it has no chance at all. So we're just gonna go with the Noctowl after they bring their Pelipper. And the reason I did not bring my Zapdos is because right now what Macargos do is use Incinerate and not Rock Throw. So we might have a better matchup against Macargo with our Zapdos if something goes horribly wrong, rather than our Noctowl over here. So we can still pressure some shields with our Sky Attacks here. So here comes the second shield. Wow, they can format down after this move. So I'm just like, if they throw the move, I'm just gonna let it go, no reason at all to block, and we can still farm down now with our Zapdos. I'm just gonna sacrifice one shield and then continue the farm down, and whatever they have in the back, even the Macargo cannot stand our energy right now, because here comes my Thunderbolt, and I believe that I have to swap out right now. Yes, here it is, and I will try to force their last pick, which is the Tropius. Wonderful news for my Blizzard. With no shields up, Whiskas can just obliterate any grass type out there, and they have no chance with Macargo, and we're just gonna take the victory. Next up, everyone, and we're facing a Shadow Charmer again, then the Shadow Granbull. That's horrible, but I decided to go for the switch for some weird reason, so I'm just gonna throw in there my Noctowl. Let's see how well we can handle things right now. Let's go with the Shadow Ball. If they take that, this is gonna do a lot of damage, about 90% of the remaining HP that they have. Look at that, at the red, and we can safely farm down. I decided to let that go as well, because I don't think that it is gonna be much of a big difference if I shield or not, so it will be just a waste of shields due to the charm damage, which is severely big. So here comes now the Sky Attack. We took out the shield, that's awesome, and I'm gonna come back now with my Whiskas. I will try to take one more shield out of them. So here comes my Mud Bomb, and they're just gonna throw in there their Trevenant. Okay, we can do this, trainers, because one Drill Bag is more than enough to finish off the Trevenant. So here comes the Seed Bomb. Okay, I don't care at all. I overfarmed so that now they might do not know how much energy we have, and we are super close to another run. We can do it because they did not know how to count the Drill Bags, I guess. And yeah, who knows how to count Zapdos's moves, right? It is not that common Pokemon to use out there. So we're just gonna take out the Trevenant, fall to the charm damage, but we still have Whiskas, which can finish off the job and grant us another victory. So next match, everyone, again some numbers, and we're gonna face Drapion up in the lead. Another good lead, too many good leads today, I gotta admit, but Whiskas is just a beast for the current meta, and you can go pretty well on MX Cup, whatever you might face with your Whiskas. Even against the Frostlass, you have a nice chance of winning. Grass types are the only thing that this thing is afraid of. However, Drapion can still pressure the Whiskas down, because it can tank one Mud Bomb, and you can see here that the Crunch is just gonna do some really nice damage, and I'm trying to go here for the Blizzard. Oh my goodness, it did not happen at all. That was so frustrating at the moment. But we still have two flying Pokemon at the back, and they have the Meganium. So we're just gonna go here for the Sky Attack. Sky Attack is just gonna do a lot of damage, so I'm expecting a shield at this point. So here it is, awesome. And let's go now with some more damage, because we can tank another Frezzyplant, no biggie at all. Noctowl is such a beast in this current meta for MX Cup. And now we can go for our Sky Attack. We might expect here a Drapion to return, so I'm just smashing that Zapdos switch, and here comes the Drapion. Now we can farm it down with one shield, and let's see now what they have at the back, and here comes the Whiskas. Let's do it, trainers. What do you think? This Zapdos taking out Nidokings taking out Whiskases on the meta. What do you think? This thing is absolutely a beast for the MX Cup. I'm just gonna keep playing that Pokemon. If you have a better team composition, be sure to let me know down in the comments what is your thinking behind that. And we're just gonna finish off the match with Shadow Zapdos. Next one, and Whiskas is gonna face Dragalge. This is the match that we are wanting against our Pokemon. So here comes now the Greninja. Greninja can seriously do some really nice work against our team if we're not careful, because we do not have a clear answer to that thing. You might think that Zapdos is doing a very nice job against the water type, but generally that may be true, but here you can see that we might struggle against Greninja because of the bubble damage and the night slashes. So we're lagging again, that is so frustrating, and we have the Drill Bag ready to go. Let's go. I'm thinking that we can force a shield, yes, and I'm going for another one, but perhaps Greninja has a higher attack stat. I'm not sure about it, I have to check it out. So down we go, we both have no shields at all, and right here I'm bringing my my Whisk has to farm down, and with no shields at both ends, I am really believing that we can do it. So here comes the farm down. Awesome, down goes Greninja, and Trevenant! Let's go, trainers! Blizzard is just gonna obliterate the thing, and now we are just gonna finish off the match here against Dragalge. I hoped to go for a Blizzard again, but then I remember, don't do that again, don't do that again. Just finish off the match with Noctowl. You can still tank and outrage, right? Right, look at that. 1, 2, 3, boom, gang shot. Oh my, I was, wow, yeah, okay. That was a gang shot that we survived. Wow, Noctowl finishing off the job because it is such a beast, and IVs might matter in the end, so consider using a good IV Noctowl, not whatever you find in your way. Gang shot, oof. So last match, everyone, and let's see how well we can do against another Charmer, this time the Wigglytuff. Let's go with the Blizzard straight. I'm not expecting a shield at all, so down goes a lot of HP, and now we're gonna bring Noctowl. Our opponent decides to stay in because they were super close to an Ice Beam, I guess, but we have what it takes to finish off the match because they have that Alola Marowak at the back, and whatever else is, I believe that it is super weak to the flying type moves, because otherwise why should they throw in there their Alola Marowak? So here comes now the sky attacks. Another one is just gonna provoke a shield at this point, and we can just go right straight ahead with a Shadow Ball to finish it off. But because they had shields, I was just like, let's throw the sky attacks, they're a cheaper move and still can do the job that we need. So here comes now a move, and I'm like, bring it on, whatever it is, we're just gonna survive it. So at this point, they're just gonna throw another one. No, I'm not in any desire to block, so we're just gonna finish off the match with Zapdos, gonna force the swap, the bailout, right? Yeah, I hope so. So that's all, trainers. What do you think? And yeah, down they go. What do you think? What are your thoughts about this team composition? I believe that Shadow Zapdos is really putting up some work on the meta, and I'm really glad that some subscribers wanted that Shadow Zapdos to be showcased in the future. So there you have it. Thank you for watching, trainers. I hope you like and subscribe to the channel, because it really, really helps, and we can spread the word out that we really exist out there, because we just reached and surpassed the 1,000 subscriber mark, and let's go to the double 1,000. Wow, I said finally to the double 1,000 subscriber mark till the end of Easter. Can we do it? Perhaps we can, and with your help, I think that we can do whatever we want with this channel. So thank you for watching, and I hope to see you all into the next one. Take care, everyone.